In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to set up a VCS control in VMware with a host that has less than the recommended 6 GB of RAM. First, you'll need to make sure you've downloaded the OVA file from the cisco.com website. Then we will import it into the VMware player. To do this, select Import from the File menu. This will then bring up a dialog box asking you to locate the file. Select the OVA file and click Open. VMware will then prompt you for the name of the virtual machine you wish to set up. In the video, I'll call mine VCS3. Click Import and this will start the process off. After 3 to 5 minutes, the import will complete and you're ready to launch the VM. The import is now completed and the VM is ready to launch. If you try to launch the VM now, you will get a message advising you that your host does not have enough RAM to support the VM and you should adjust it. To adjust, select the Settings menu and go to Processors and Memory. Reduce the number of processors down to 1 and the RAM to a suitable number for your system. I have chosen 1 GB. This will now allow you to start the VM. You will see later on when the system boots, there will be a hardware failure warning and the TANDBERG application will fail to launch. Now the system has completed booting, we need to log in as root and the default password is TANDBERG. This will show you a load of alerts and warnings. Don't worry about those for the moment, we can address those later. What we're doing next is we're going to run the cat command against etc, hwconfig, hwcheck. This will show you the hardware check script that looks for the amount of installed memory and compares it against the memory that the system's expecting. At the top of the page, you can see expected memory, 4 GB, and then about halfway down the page, you can see the hardware check routine. The first part of the routine shows you a command, cat proc meminfo awk memtotal. That will print out the amount of installed memory in this computer. What I'm doing now is I'm going to go in and edit that file, but the file system is mounted as read-only. Therefore, any changes we make to this file will not be saved, which I'm demonstrating here now. As you may have noticed at the bottom of the screen, there was a number of errors when I tried to save that file. So, to overcome this, we're going to unmount the file system with the unmount command, and then we're going to remount it as read-write with the mount slash rw slash o remount forward slash. There we go. I then re-enter VI and enter a new line underneath expected memory with the appropriate variable that we noted in the previous step. Then I'm going to delete the line that's expecting 4 GB. Okay, so now we save the file by pressing escape, colon, W, and then enter. And then we do the same again, escape, colon, Q, and then enter. File's now saved. And what we need to do is shut down the VCS and restart it to allow for this change to take effect. Once the hardware check mod has been applied and the VCS successfully rebooted, you will want to log in using the admin password, which is TANDBERG once again in capitals. And this time you'll see the same warnings you saw when you logged in as root, but it will also ask you whether you wish to run the install wizard. Select yes to this and follow the on-screen instructions. Now the initial configuration is completed, we should be able to access the VCS from the web interface using your favourite web browser. So load up your web browser and enter the IP address you gave in the previous step. If you go to the Alerts and Warnings page, you'll find that some of the default links are missing. So what we're going to do, we're going to add those back in via SSH using a command, xcommand default links add. To run the commands, you'll need to log in as admin using your favourite terminal emulator. This can also be done from the box. So here I am using iterm and the built-in SSH shell. The password once again is admin and TANDBERG. So you'll see all the familiar warnings you got, except this time you won't get a little dollar prompt, it'll just be an OK prompt. Once you've got that prompt, enter your xcommand's default links add. You'll come back with the status OK message. That's it, all of your links are added now. If we switch back to our web interface and refresh the warnings page, you'll find that the warning about the default links will have now gone. You'll probably still have a warning about MTP, default passwords, general errors that you can sort out.